Hello everyone, welcome to EduStudy. My name is Rajiv. In this video lecture, we will discuss theory of consumers' behavior, part 2. So part 1 of the theory of consumers' behavior is already uploaded to EduStudy channel. So you should go to the playlist of EduStudy channel. There you will get the playlist as a microeconomics or economics for class 12 student. So this kind of playlist is created there. So you have to go to the playlist. And otherwise you do not find the playlist, then at the end of this video you will get the link to part 1. And if you are from Assamese medium student, then also you will get the link. Otherwise you may go to the playlist. So you have the two options. So before watching this part 2 of the video, part 2 of the theory of consumers' behavior, please watch the part 1. So if you have not subscribed my channel yet, then please subscribe it. So for the latest notification, latest update, you have to press the bell icon. Then whenever I will upload the videos, you will get notified. So let me start. So our first in first PPT, here we have preliminary notations and assumptions. So in preliminary notations and assumptions, that means we are going to discuss the consumer's budget. So in consumer's budget, we will discuss consumer's budget, then budget set, then budget line. So in this way, we will discuss many things here. So whatever we can complete here in the 30 minutes or maybe 45 minutes. So please take your pen and paper while watching the video and pay your attention to here. You have to treat the video as your classroom, then only you will learn a lot. So whatever my attempt is to teach you, that will be successful here. So first one, preliminary notations and assumptions. So we will discuss here preliminary notation, what kind of preliminary notations and assumptions required here to discuss the consumer's budget. So first preliminary notations here, there are only two goods. And second one here is the a fixed amount of money income to spend on the two goods, the prices of which are given in the market. So here three things you have to keep remember. First one is that there are only two goods only in the market. You have to keep remember. Otherwise you have to keep remember like this: the consumer consumes only two goods. Another one, fixed amount of money income of the consumer, that is money income of the consumer is given. And next one is the prices of the commodities or the prices of the goods, whatever we discuss here, the two goods, their prices are fixed. That means their prices are given in the market and the prices will not be changed. And similarly, the money income of the consumer will not be changed. So during our discussion, we have to assume all this. Okay. So let us see what is there in your book. And the book I recommend here, the book provided from your college or school level, the book given by the college or your school, that is required here. And whenever you watch the video, please open your book, open your notebook, as well as keep ready to your pen. Then you have to write important things, whatever I will tell you and whatever you will get on your screen. So please open your book now and let us start from your book. In your preliminary notations and assumptions from your book, they are written: a consumer in general consumes many goods, but for simplicity we shall consider the consumer's choice problem in a situation where there are only two goods. We will refer to two goods as good one and good two. Any combination of the amount of two goods will be called a consumption bundle, or in short, a bundle. In general, we shall use the variable x1 to denote the amount of good 1 and x2 to denote the amount of good 2. x1 and x2 can be positive or zero. x1 comma x2 would mean the bundle consisting of x1 amount of good 1 and x2 amount of good 2. For particular values of x1 and x2, x1 comma x2 would give us a particular bundle. For example, the bundle 5,10 consists of 5 units of good 1 and 10 units of good 2. The bundle 10,5 consists of 10 units of good 1 and 5 units of good 2. So this is all about preliminary notations and assumptions in your book. So let me explain to you. So here it is said that for our simplicity, that means in the market, what happens in the market, there are many goods, okay, many goods to consume for the consumer. But here our simplicity, that means for making easier our whatever we are discussing here, consumer's budget approach. So for making simplicity of the approach, we will just assume here that the consumer consumes only two goods. So these two goods are said here, it is said that these two goods are said here, good one, or you may say good first, or second one is the good second. Good second. So good first is referred here x1 here. Complete in the complete discussion of this consumer's theory, you will get x1, and good second you will get here x2. You have to keep remember, and their prices are fixed, and their prices you will get here p1, and for the price of good 2 you will get the p2. So these are also important here. And money income is taken here as like m. You have to keep remember it also, money income is m here. So here another concept we required here, consumers bundle. Here you have consumers bundle. What is consumers bundle? Consumers bundle. So what is consumers bundle? This O should not be written here. Consumers bundle, BUNDLE. Consumers bundle, or in simple it is said as bundle. So what are these? So consumers bundle means the quantity of the two goods that make a bundle. That means suppose x1 quantity of the good one is taken in his bundle, in his basket, as well as the x2 quantity of good 2 is taken in your basket, and his basket now becomes the bundle. This is the consumer's bundle. That means these two are the quantity of the goods. Consumer bundle means the bundle that consists of the quantity that is choiced by the consumer. Quantities of the two goods that is choiced by the consumer is taken as together. That is together, if you take the combination, if you make the combination of these two goods quantity, then that quantity, that these two quantities are called the consumer's bundle. So this is important here. So friends, let's come to the next PPT. Here also consumer's budget, we have the consumer's budget. What is there in consumer's budget? So we will discuss here. So consumer's budget, a consumer's budget is the real purchasing power. This is important here, real purchasing power. You have to keep remember real purchasing power. That means what is consumer's budget? It is the real purchasing power with which he can purchase quantities of two goods given their prices. Okay, it's important here. So real purchasing power here, what do you mean by real purchasing power? So real purchasing power, it is said that real purchasing power is the money income. That is money income. You have to keep remember, this is the income of the consumer. Real purchasing power, that is purchasing power. That is, what is the purchasing power? Money is the purchasing power. So here, what is the purchasing power? Purchasing power is the money income. That is money income of the consumer. So consumer's budget is the consumer's money income with which he can purchase quantities of two goods. That means the quantities of two goods, we assume there are two goods. These were the good one, that is said x1, and good two, that is x2. So these two are the goods. So to purchase these two goods, he requires a money income, and that money income is the real purchasing power, and that is called the consumer's budget. And here one thing is important, their prices. That means the prices of these two goods, whatever he had taken these two goods. So these two goods prices are given here. That means the prices are fixed here. So here it is said in your book, let us consider a consumer who has only a fixed amount of money income to spend on two goods, the prices of which are given in the market. So here also same kind of definition is given. That means the money income, fixed money income, and that is the consumer is ready to spend for the two goods, and the prices of the two goods are given in the market. That means the prices are fixed. Okay, given prices means the prices are fixed here. Prices cannot be changed. So the consumer cannot buy any and every combination of the two goods that she may want to consume. The consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend on the prices of the two goods and the income of the consumer. So here important line is given in your book. The consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depends on the prices of the two goods and the income of the consumer. Here may be the question, short question. So on which parameters the consumption bundles of the consumer depends? So you have to write the consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend on the prices of the two goods and the income of the consumer. So this is here important, friends. So next here, consumption bundle, the definition of consumption bundle is given in my PPT here. What is the consumption bundle here written? So the consumption bundle that are available to the consumer, it is also said in your first page of the book. So available to the consumer depend on the prices of the two goods and the income of the consumer. This is important here. Next, given her fixed income, the prices of the two goods, the consumer can afford to buy only those bundles which cost her less than or equal to her income. Suppose here the money income of the consumer is rupees 20. Okay, so now she wants to buy x1 and x2 quantity, x1 and x2 quantity of two goods. Then the cost of buying these two goods must be less than or equal to 20. Only then she can purchase. So here it is said that the fixed income and the prices of the two goods, the consumer can afford to buy only those bundles she can buy which cost her less than or equal to their or her income. Here you may say her income or his income. The consumer may be male or female, we can't say here. So this is all about the consumption bundle and the consumer's budget. So next we will discuss here budget set. What is budget set? So budget set is also given in your book. So look at the PPT here, budget set. All those bundles that satisfy this criterion are said to form a part of what is called the budget set. The consumer can choose to consume out of any of these bundles. So what is budget set here said? About the budget set, here it is said that the bundles that satisfy this criterion. This criterion means that can satisfy, that means the bundles that are set according to the money income of the consumer as well as the prices of the two goods, that is the criterion, are said to form a part of what is called the budget set. Budget, this is the definition of budget set. Or otherwise you may write the definition from your book also. There also a very nice definition is given. The set of bundles available to the consumer is called a budget set. Here in your book it is given. So this definition also you can write as your answer. The set of bundles available to the consumer is called the budget set. But the set of bundles available to the consumer, here you have to include, while writing the set of bundles available to the consumer, while you write, that time you have to include there given money income of the consumer. It is important here, money income of the consumer is given as well as the prices are given. So prices are given and money income are given. So these two, money income and prices are given, these two are important here while giving the definition of the budget set. So the consumer can choose to consume out of any of these bundles. So out of any of these bundles, that means these bundles, the cost of these bundles are less than or equal to the money income of the consumer. Suppose money income of the consumer is here M, and if we suppose the two commodities are X1, amount of the good one is consumed by the consumer. This is also written in your book. Please refer your book also here. X1 unit of good one is consumed by the consumer, as well as the X2 unit of the good two is consumed by the consumer, and their respective prices. If we take the respective prices of x1, the prices of x1, that means per unit of x1 is that is p1, and similarly if we suppose per unit of price of x2 is p2, okay, then what will be the total cost of x1? The total cost of x1, this is the price per unit. So total cost here will be p1 x1, and the total cost of x2 will be p2 x2. Okay, if you add both of them, then you will get the total expenditure. This is the total cost or total expenditure that the consumer has to pay, and this total cost or total expenditure must be less than or equal to m, that is m is the given money income of the consumer. So here, what is the budget set? Here budget set, that means the bundle that is consumed by the consumer, that bundle is here x1 and x2. So this x1 and x2, this x1 and x2 is the budget set here. These are the budget set here. So you have to keep remember. So what is budget constraint? Here budget constraint also given, the expenditure on both goods must be less than or equal to the money income of the consumer. The expenditure, I mean here, as I told you here, this P1 X1 and P2 X2, this is the expenditure, this is the total expenditure, and this total expenditure must be less than, here it is said less than or equal, this must be less than or equal to money income of the consumer. Money income of the consumer here is M. So you can write the equation as P1 X1 plus P2 X2, and this is less than or equal to M. So this is called the budget constraint. This is the constraint, this is the limit, this M is the limit. As why? As because beyond this, if his expenditure goes beyond this, then he cannot afford to purchase those commodities or those goods. So therefore this is the budget constraint. So in your book, the budget constraint, this budget constraint is given as a 2.1, like this kind of equation or this kind of number is given, 2.1 number is given here. So you have to also refer from your book. So keep it remember, open your book always whenever you watch the video. So this is about the budget set. I hope you have understood this. So let's go to the budget line. What is the budget line? Okay, before going to budget line, we have to discuss one example is given there, example 2.1 in your book. So what is this? Let us. So here in your example 2.1, it is said that the money income of the consumer, that is M, as we say here M in our budget constraint. Suppose that M, you have to keep remember, M is the money income of the consumer, that M is equal to rupees 20. It is rupees 20, you have to keep remember here. This is according to your example in the book. And price of the both of the goods, price of the both of the goods, that is P1 for the X1 good and P2, that is P2 is for the X2 amount of good, that is the rate of the X2, that both the rate are here rupees 5, both are rupees 5. Okay, so now here the bundles that the consumer can afford to buy are the bundles here, as I tell you, the bundles, that means the amount of the both of the goods amount here, the bundles may be 0, 0, similarly 0, 1, similarly 0, 2, 0, 4, but not the 0, 5. Why? So as we know, these are the bundles, these are the quantities. So if you put here, this is the quantity, total quantity, and these two are the rate, this is the rate, okay, P1 and P2 are the rate. So what is your budget constraint? Budget constraint is here that P1 X1 plus P2 X2, this should be less than or equal to M. That means you can go equal to M, but not greater than M. So here what happens, here 0, 0, both the quantities are 0. Then if you find the total cost for X1 commodity, then it will be P1 X1. Then P1 X1 means what? This is P1. P1 is the price of the commodity. Here first one should be treated as the commodity one. So this is the commodity one, and its quantity is X1. So in place of X1 you have to take 0, and multiplication here P1. What is the value of P1 here? 5. So 5 into 0, it will be 0. Similarly, it must be 0 here as because here also the 0. So it is also 0. If you add both of them, then you will get 0, and 0 is less than M. Here the value of M is here, what is? That is 20. So it is less than M. Similarly, here you will get less than M. Similarly, less than M. Here also, here you will get equal to M, as because the cost for first of the good will be, it will be like this, 5 into 0, 5 is the rate here, then you will get 0, and plus here it will be 4, here it is the 4, 4 is quantity, then 4 into the price, that is 5. So 5 into 4, it will be 20, and 20 is equal to the M, so it's equal to M. Then what will happen to this bundle? In this bundle, what will happen? Here cost of the first commodity will be 0, but cost of the second commodity, that is here quantity, is 5. That means value of x2 is 5 here, and the value of p2, what is the value of p2? Value of p2 is here 5. So 5 is 25, and 25 is greater than 20. So this is beyond the reach of the consumer. So these are the consumer's bundle. These are the consumer's bundle, and which from these bundles we have to find many more bundles. You can compose many more bundles here, and out of which you will get the exactly rupees 20. Those bundles are here optimal bundles, and by using those bundles we will find the budget line. So next we will discuss here budget line. So what is the budget line? We'll discuss in our next PPT. Budget line, here it is said, budget line. So what is the budget line? Here the graphical representation of all such bundles which cost the consumer exactly his money income is called the budget line. So what is the budget line? Whatever we discuss already, and the graphical representation of that things, that means such bundles which cost the consumer exactly his money income. Now we discussed already the bundles. We got a bundle there 0,4. So for this bundle we got the cost exactly equal to M, that is exactly equal to M. The value of M we took there 20. So the cost of this bundle was M. Also several bundles are there in your example. The example 2.1, I am going to 2.1. So what are those bundles? So that is 1,3 also, you can take 1,3 bundle. From this bundle you will also get M equal to here 20. Okay, not M equal to, that is the total expenditure cost. The total cost is equal to 20, you will get, that is equal to M. If you take P 3,1, then also here you have to put P1 X1 plus P2 X2. Here you have to put the value. Then P1 X1, what is the value of P1? P1 as we have taken in the previous PPT, that P1, P2 are equal to 5. Then P1, you have to take the value of P1 is 5 into X1. X1 is 1 plus, and value of P2 is 5 also, and value of X2 is 3 here. Then it is 5 ones of 5 plus 5 threes of 15. Then it will be equal to 20. So the cost is here 20, and cost is 20, and this is equal to M, that is money income of the consumer. So what are the bundles exactly? That the cost of the bundles is equal to the money income. Those bundles are represented here within this line. That means on this line those bundles will be represented. Those bundles we'll find on this line. And this line is the graphical, you may say this is the graphic. So this is the graphical representation of the such bundles, such kind of bundles, 0,4, 1,3. Here also many more bundles, 2,2, you may say 2,2 is another bundle. Similarly, here you have the 3,1, another bundle. So 4,0 is another bundle. So all these bundles will be represented. All these bundles will lie on this line, and this line is the budget line, you have to keep remember. So on the budget line there will not be constraint. So on the budget line there will be equation, as because the cost on the budget line, the bundles that lies on the budget line, their cost will be equal to M. So therefore, here you will get the equation, not the constraint. Then the equation of the budget line will be P1 X1 plus P2 X2, that is equal to M, and this is called the equation. This is the equation of the budget line. So you have to keep remember, this is the equation of the budget line. Okay, and here what you have to take, before taking here, let me erase it. So okay, it's erased now. So here you have to take good one. You have to write here good one on the x-axis. Here it is good one. This is the x-axis. Okay, good one means here we have the good one x1. So x1, the quantities of x1 will be taken on this line, and this is O or 0, you may say O or 0, same here origin point, that is the origin point. And here it is y, this is y, and on the y-axis we will write here good 2. Here we will write what? Good 2. And good 2 is here we have taken x2. So their combination we will take here. Their combination, as I tell you, the combination is the bundle, that is x1 comma x2. This is the bundle, and these bundles are taken, and the bundles, which bundles are taken here? Those bundles that's cost equal to the money income of the consumer, and those kind of bundles are taken on this, on this line. This line is the budget line. Okay, you have to keep it remembered. This is the budget line, and budget line's equation is this, and the points under these budget lines, under this budget line, the points, these points, this, all these points, all these points has the value of P1 x1 plus P2 x2 less than M. Their value are less than M. And similarly, the points above the budget line, that means beyond the budget line, you may say beyond the budget line, their equation will be, their constraint will be like this: P1 x1 plus P2 x2 is greater than M. That means cost will be greater than the money income of the consumer. So this is important. This is all about the budget line. So let us check what is there in your book. Whatever I have tell you here, that thing is there given in your book. You have to just simply read the book and try to understand, and you have to repeat the video again if you don't understand. So one more thing is they're given. What is that? Let us take it. They're taken the equation of the budget line. So here the equation, what is the equation of the budget line? The equation of the budget line here is the P1 X1. This P1 X1 is taken, and here one simplification has done. So we have to take the amount of X2 here. What is the amount of X2? To find out the amount of X2, please keep the P2 X2 on the left hand side, and here P1 X1, this would be taken to the right hand side here, and then it will be minus here, as because here is the plus, so therefore it will be minus here P1 X1. Then what happens? Just simply you have to take the X2, then you have to take this P2 here also, then it will be M minus P1 X1 divided by it is P2. Okay, this P2 is taken here. So then what will happen to here? It will be M by P2. It will be M by P2, then minus, you have taken here minus, then it will be P1 by P2, and X1 is taken here. That means P1 by P2 whole into X1. You have to take here X1. Okay, this is X1. So this is taken, and this is given here as the equation 2.3. There in your book it is given 2.3. Equation 2.3 is given. This is, so here it is said the budget line. I am reading from your book, so try to understand and concentrate on the video. The budget line is a straight line with the horizontal intercept M by P1 and vertical intercept M by P2. That is, on this budget line, you will get the, in horizontal line there, in the budget lines horizontal, there you will get the M by P1. What is M by P1? That is on the horizontal. What is the horizontal side? This is the horizontal side. This is the horizontal side. Okay. And here in this point, you will get M by P1. M by P1 you will get. And here you will get M by P2. And here we have also M by P2 here. This is the M by P2. Then what are these? And this is horizontal intercept. This M by P1. This M by P1, as because this is on the horizontal side, as because we have taken the X1 and the price of X1 is P1, so therefore you have to keep remember horizontal. That means the on the horizontal axis we have taken the X1 and its respective price is here P1, and so M by P1, that is the horizontal intercept. It may be changed according to your graphical representation. If your graphical representation on your graphical representation, that means on your diagram, if you represent here X2, then horizontal intercept will be M by P2 here. So similarly vertical will be here on, but here according to our diagram it is M by P2. M by P2 is the vertical intercept here. So vertical intercept is here. This is the vertical intercept. So what is the vertical intercept here? So vertical intercept and horizontal intercepts are discussed on our next PPT here. Look, the intercepts, so what is the definition of intercept is here given. The intercepts are the maximum of each good that the consumer can afford to buy. That means what is the intercept? Intercept are the maximum of each good. That means we have taken here the X1 and X2. There are two goods, X1 goods and X2 goods. Two goods are taken here and their respective prices are also given here, P1 and P2. And money income, what is the money income? That is M. M is taken here. That is the money income. Okay. Now, by using this money income, what is the maximum amount of the each good the consumer can afford to buy? That is the intercepts. So intercepts are two. One is the horizontal, another one is the vertical. You have to keep remember vertical and horizontal. Vertical will be on this line, on this x-axis, and horizontal will be on the y-axis. So you have to keep remember. So now we have here the money income. So by using this money income, how much quantity of X1 the consumer can buy? Here horizontal intercept, the definition of horizontal intercept is given, M by P1. The consumer buys only good one, good to them, quantity of good is zero. That means on our budget line we got a bundle, that is 0,4. One bundle is this and another bundle is 4,0. When the P1 and P2, this P1 and this P2, these two are equal to rupees 5, that time what happens? That time the cost, this cost is equal to 20. That means this bundle is on the budget line. Similarly, this bundle is on the budget line, as because its cost is also rupees 20. So whenever the consumer goes to this bundle, that time what happens? He will purchase the maximum of here, maximum of X2. Okay, as because this is the amount of X2, the amount of X2 is positive here. So here it is zero. So this is for X2. That means the maximum amount of, maximum quantity of X2 he can purchase. He can purchase is, that is M by P2. M by P2. As because P2 is for X2, so we are taking here F for X2, as because here 0,4. 0,4 means first value is the X1 value and second one is the X2 value. So here the vertical intercept, the vertical intercept will be, first of all I am discussing here vertical intercept as because I have taken the bundle here in reverse cases. First of all I have to take this, so let me take this first one. So this one, the x1 x2, so horizontal intercept we are discussing. So it will be, so horizontal intercept for this bundle will be M by P1, as because we are discussing about X1 here. X1 is, so therefore M by P1. So what is M by P1 here? M is equal to rupees 20, and what is the value of P1? That is 5, and they equal to 4, and this is the 4. This is the maximum quantity. This is the maximum quantity. Okay, we are taking the X1. So this is the maximum quantity of the goods. This is the horizontal intercept. Okay, similarly vertical intercept, you have to find M by P2. This one you have to take. So what is the value of M here? 20, and P2 value, that is 5. It's also 4, and this 4 is equal to this one value of X2, that is maximum value. So maximum value of X2, that is called the vertical intercept here. That means the whatever you have taken on the vertical axis or the y-axis, that is the vertical intercept, and whatever you have taken the x-axis is the horizontal intercept. You have to keep remember. Or if you go to the diagram also, let me erase before discussion. So on this diagram, what happens? The maximum also given here in the maximum amount. So this is the maximum amount. Let me take the pen. So maximum amount, this is the maximum amount, this is the maximum amount, this is the limit. Here also limit of x1, this is the limit of x1, this is the limit of x2, okay? And this is the maximum amount of x2, maximum amount of x2.